It is just a thought, honestly, good. I don't please.
It's me. What you want to hear? Warned of aftershocks after a powerful earthquake struck off the country's west coast.
The quake was a magnitude of 8.1 and killed at least 32 people.
A warning has been issued for the region.
So far, there have been 65 aftershocks. The strongest was magnitude 6.1. However, the next 24 hours, we could see a shock which is strong.
U.S. authorities are warning that Hurricane Irma will devastate parts of the United States and it makes landfall at one time.
U.S. Federal Emergency Management Agency Chief Scott Long says no one in Florida has experienced a storm with the intensity of what we're bearing down on the state.
He says the wind and storm surge from the Category 4 hurricane will be devastating.
Hurricane Irma continues to be a threat and is going to devastate the United States, either Florida or some of the southeastern states. This is a complex forecast. Anybody from Alabama to North Carolina should be watching this storm very closely.
Well, there's this week, Hurricane Irma, and also a trail of destruction in the Caribbean affecting estimated 1.2 million people. South Korean nuclear experts checking for contamination of North Korea's sixth and largest nuclear test say they found traces of radio xenon gas. They've added that it's too early to specify whether the contamination was caused by the North. The Nuclear Safety and Security Commission said it's been conducting tests on land, air and water samples after North Korea's nuclear test on Sunday. The commission is analysing how the xenon entered South Korean territory and will decide on the source of the result.
The opera sending strike attacks to the Philippines to train local forces in the fight against Islamic State is being described as a strategic shift for Australia.
Defence Minister Maureen May yesterday, in with her Filipino counterpart, Islamic State are trying to establish a strategic foothold in the southern Philippine city of Marawi. Professor John Blackburn from ANU has told AM Australia's focus has long been on supporting the United States in conflict in the Middle East, but that's changing.
No one is really going to prioritise our neighbourhood if we don't. And so, recognise that and prioritise it. Discreet, modest, respectful, and behind-the-scenes engagement with the Philippines, mindful that this is not actually a commitment of combat troops.
Federal Government Prime Minister Angus Taylor has defended the right to discuss the need for religious protection during the same-sex marriage debate. Matthew Bullock reports from Toronto.
The campaigning for the yes and no cases in legalising same-sex marriage has begun in earnest.
The Assistant Minister Angus Taylor says the debate needs to include discussion on how the beliefs of individuals will be protected in the event same-sex marriage is legalised.
That is absolutely crucial in any change. And to argue otherwise, I think this is ingenious.
But Labor's Nick Champion argues it's really part of a scare campaign by those opposed to the change, because they think they'll lose the survey.
And so they have to resort to an argument about religious protection, which is a separate argument.